I just made this burn forest, and now I'm going to add and animate a camera to get this result. Let me show you. The goal here is to show you how the camera works, so I won't show you how to make the forest, but I have another video for that if you're interested. Ready? Let's add that camera. Plus cinematic cine camera actor. And there it is. You can see we just got a camera view here. Move this and it changes the camera position. You can move and rotate it just like you would with any other objects. Another way to move it is to click perspective, then select the camera. Now you are in the camera view. I go into this mode so often when working on my projects. Now to get off the camera view, you can just press this eject button. See, here I have the camera view with a pin button. The reason to pin it is for if I wanted to select another object while still having the view. Select the camera again, and it's back. Press escape to unselect everything. You could select the camera from the outliner too. Click this pin button and see by yourself what happens exactly. You see, I just selected this burn tree, yet I still have the camera view. That simple. Okay, next up I want to show you some of the most important camera settings you need to know about. Get in the view and make sure the camera is selected. Let's start with focal length. This is the zoom level on the camera. Higher number, bigger zoom. Lower number, and you can get a wide angle. For this project, I'll keep it at 35. What if the camera is too fast and you don't have enough control? Then, you would simply press the camera speed button and adjust as you want. Next, we have the focus settings. Select the picker, then pick an object that will set the focus distance. You see what it did, right? Now this tree is clear and the background blurry. Click on the picker again, but this time choose a far object, like this tree maybe. Now that you understand how this part works, select back the burnt tree, then let's move on. Close the focus settings and find current aperture. This is the amount of blur, so lower number, more blurry. High number, and the whole scene looks clear. Let's keep it at 2.8 for this. The goal is just to have a camera that goes from here to about there. Yeah, but how do I do that? Let me show you. So, click on this camera clip, then you got two options. Pick this one. Now it's asking you to choose a name for the sequencer. This, my friend, is the sequencer. You can have a camera movement as well as animating objects, characters, and even metahumans. But for now, let's just focus on the camera. Select it, then just drag and drop in the sequencer. Since we just added the camera, we now see the timeline with all its options. Remember when I showed you how to change the zoom and focus distance? The same settings are here too, but all we need for now are the transform options. Location, rotation, and scale. All we need for this simple movement is the location. Let's see which one is the correct direction. X? Nope. Control Z to undo that. If like me you want to undo a Control Z, do Control Y. Let's try Y. Yeah, that's what we need. Find the starting position of the camera, then press on this keyframe button to add a keyframe. Now, listen closely, because this part is where most people get confused. Let's play it and let it go to the end frame. You could also manually move the cursor line. Now look attentively. I'm on the last frame and I'm moving the camera to where I want it to be. Instead of changing the number below, you can also use the middle click on your mouse to move the camera directly. Now look, this is the exact part most people get confused at. I move the cursor line and oh no, it didn't save my camera position. Why is that? Simply because you never told Unreal to do so. You just need to press this auto keyframe button. Now try it, and it still didn't work as expected. If that happens, just select camera component. Okay, one more try. Look at this, it created a new keyframe for me, so now we got two different keyframes. The camera don't even need to be selected for this to work, so I'm not totally sure why it didn't work the first time. There is currently a big ease with this movement. See, at the beginning it's slow, then slowly gets faster until a certain speed, then slowly stops. That's not what I want. I'd like the camera to keep the exact same speed for the whole shot. It's simple, just select the two keyframes, right click on it, then select linear. It's working. The camera now keeps the same speed. Now I want to put keyframes that will change the focus distance from this to this tree back there. It works pretty much the same way as the camera location. I want that starting here, there is a keyframe which represents a focus distance at the burnt tree. And right there, you select the camera in the outliner. Make sure auto keyframe is on. Then from the camera setting, we are going to create a new keyframe. Like we did earlier in the video, select the picker, then pick the far tree. We got the new keyframe. Let's see how it looks. Beautiful. I want those to be linear too. See this grid with all these settings? Oh, you don't? That means you're not in the correct mode. Just click perspective and make sure you are in cinematic viewport, not default viewport. Well, now you got the grid settings, so use them if you want. You got a selection of grids, plus you can set a safe zone. This here is, for example, if you want to do a TikTok video, the format is 9:16. Now, let's export the video. Open the File Explorer with your project folder. Create a new folder and name it anything, but I'll pick PNG. This is where we'll save the animation. See this clip? Click on the three dots next to it, then just make sure it's Movie Render Queue. Now click on it. We got some export settings. The output is simply where the PNG images will be exported. We can change this to our PNG folder later. Just click on Settings. This is the format the animation will be exported at. I don't want JPEG. I'll instead choose PNG sequence. You could export like that, but if you want better quality, add a little anti-aliasing. These are the sample counts. I like to put them at 3, 2. Now the output. Just select the folder where you want the PNG to be exported at. Just one more thing you should know about before exporting. This line here represents at what point in the timeline should it use the camera view. Of course, we want it to cover the whole zone. This green line tells when to start the render, and the red one is the end. You can choose the FPS here. Okay, I think we are ready. Just press render local, which means on your computer. Now you got the images in your PNG folder. Now you can use these to make a video using your video editor. Just make sure you're using the same resolution and FPS. I have many Unreal Engine tutorials in this playlist. Take a look.